Hello students, today we will learn about computer memory. So very first thing is, it says about what is a computer memory. See, memory plays a very important role in computer. It is the basic unit where data and instructions are stored temporarily. Let's talk about some other thing. So first of all, we talk about the primary memory. See, the primary memory is the main memory and it consists of two types. The first one is the RAM, that is random access memory, and the second one is the ROM. It stands for read only memory. Let's have a look. So very important thing is, what is primary memory? As I told you, this is also known as main memory. Why this is known as main memory? Because it holds only those data and instructions on which the computer is currently working. So here we are having RAM, and I'm going to show you some features of it. As you can see, it is a green color chip which is placed here. So here are the features of this. Very first thing it says about, it is a volatile memory. What is the meaning of volatile? Means, see, whenever the power goes off and if you have not saved your file, then the data get lost. So in that case, this is known as the RAM, or we can call it a volatile memory. Another thing is that it consists of memory chips. As you can see here, so many black chips are placed here. So it is consists of memory chips that can be read from and written to by the processor and other devices. Next, it says about the types of RAM. Here we are having three different types of RAM. First one is the DRAM, second is the SRAM, and the third one is the MRAM. Now let's have a look about DRAM. DRAM stands for dynamic RAM. So it is a very popular type of, most popular type of main memory we can say, and it is inexpensive. But we are having a various types available here. As you can see here, SDRAM, DDR SDRAM, DDR2, DDR3, DDR4 and RDRAM. See, why these are like in a sequence like DDR2, DDR3, this is because the generations, as you all know, the computers are available from generation to generation, like in first generation, second generation, third generation, so many things are changing time to time. So in the same way, these DRAMs, these are also changing timely. Okay, so next is about the SRAM. SRAM stands for static RAM. It is efficient and fast than DRAM. Another thing, it is very expensive. Now there is, it is used in small amount, like we use something in very small chunks. In the same way, we use SRAM in the small amount. Next, it says about the MRAM. MRAM stands for magnetoresistive RAM. So what it is? It is a new type of RAM. And what are the features of it? It stores the data using the magnetic charges. And do you know one thing? The other RAM use electrical charges, but this RAM use magnetic charges for storing the data. Another thing, it consume very less power. So these all are the types of RAM. Thank you for watching this video.